In the previous video, I had covered the basic degree day method. In this video, we are going to develop the on the very same concept of degree day, but this is going to be the modified degree day method. And it's very much similar to what we had previously, but it takes into account some of the disadvantages and some factors to overcome those disadvantages. But the very important, let's see and remember that it is also said as MDD, which is modified degree day method. And the formula for the fuel consumption based on the modified degree day method is very much similar to what we had previously for degree day method. And this gives the fuel consumption. Which is equal to EH, and it is given by 24 into H times degree day into some factor of C divided by TI minus T out. I hope it is visible clearly. Into K into V. So let's look at each of these factors again in detail. So I hope you remember the formula for degree day method in which my fuel consumption was given by 24H into degree days divided by TI minus T out. So these many factors were the same. Three new factors have been introduced in fuel consumption estimate based on modified degree day method, and these three are basically something to improve upon the previous method. So where the V, obviously V is already included, V was there, so V was there in the previous one also. So H is the building heating estimate, heat loss, which is the same factor we had earlier in 1 hour from the building. DD we already know is the degree days, that's the number of degree days. TI and T out are very simple. TI is the indoor temperature, T out is the design outdoor temperature, while V is again the calorific value of the fuel. And I'm very sorry, but there are different notations used at different sources, so it's very difficult to maintain the same notation for that calorific value of the fuel. Now the interesting thing comes up, which is the CD and K. So my K, I'm sorry, this is not as clear as I expected. So K is the factor of efficiency. Which is very much similar to what we had efficiency of the boiler in the previous case of degree day method. But as I said, it is one of the disadvantage of that method that we are assuming a constant efficiency of our boiler, which might not be the case for all the boilers, because if we are operating the boiler at part loads, the efficiency keeps on changing, the efficiency might reduce. So my K factor now takes into account those changes in the efficiency based on part load and based on the technology which we are using. So there are three values which are given, which is 1.0, that is 1 if we are having electric heating. That means we are assuming that all the electrical energy which is supplied to that electric heater is converted to the heating or thermal energy, while if we have gas heating, then my value is 0.55 plus minus 0.22. Okay, that's for gas heating. But if we have new homes available which have gas heating, then my efficiency is 0.65. These are new homes built after 1965. So you can understand that they are considering new homes which are built after 1965. So already this method is like 65 years old actually. And the CD is one of the most interesting thing. CD is, it's an empirical correction factor. Right? And that correction factor takes into account the heating effect, the actual heating effect versus the 65 degree Fahrenheit degree days. So usually the degree days which are recorded in our history are all based on 65 degree Fahrenheit as the balance temperature, but the balance temperature can change based on the comfort requirements, the internal heat gains of the building, etc. So the heating effects, the actual heating effect which is required is taken account into in this fact, in this method. So it is so one of the advantages is it is better than the basic degree day method, as it takes into account the correction of base or the balance temperature variation, and it also takes into account the change in the efficiency of the fuel which is burned in the process to heat our homes. So these are the two advantages, while still the disadvantages are we are having the calculation for degree days based on the same constant value of balance temperature, while the balance temperature or the comfort requirements can change during the year, and we are also not taking into account any dynamic changes which are occurring in the weather or inside the home, because in summer we might want some other temperature, comfort temperature or humidity. In the winter season we might require some other comfort temperature or humidity, and the internal gains can also keep on changing based on it is a summer, we'll have more solar loads, as I explained in the videos where I was discussing about the various loads on our building, while in the winter the solar loads will decrease. So we are still assuming a constant value of balance temperature, and that will be taken care into account while we move ahead into the next one, which is the variable based degree day method. Over there we are going to take into our account the variable balance temperature based on the specific condition of our building. So that's all which we have with respect to modified degree days method, and hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.